Hey there, Sam Bell here for Licklibrary.com and welcome to this video on John Petrucci playing style and habits. In this free guitar lesson, we're going to take a look at some of John Petrucci's habits and his own playing and how we can apply them to our own playing using some simple exercises. So, be sure to use the timestamps to fast forward to your favourite sections or watch this entire video from start to finish to get the maximum benefit from this free guitar lesson and pick up some brand new John Petrucci licks. Of course, it wouldn't be a John Petrucci lesson without any fast alternate picking. Lots of John Petrucci's licks use very accurate picking. There are two aspects of his picking that I'd like to dive into now. So the first thing is a tonal discussion. Obviously, John Petrucci uses guitars with humbuckers and he uses quite high gain amp sound as well. And often he'll be boosting his signal into the amp with an overdrive of some description. But even if you've got a high gain amp, you can get similar effect. The main takeaway from this aspect of his technique is that we don't need to put the pick too far below the strings. Let me demonstrate. So now we're zoomed in on the neck. When we're playing fast lines, we don't want the pick to get caught in the strings. If it's too far below the string, almost touching the pickup or the body, then it's going to mean there's more resistance for the pick to move through the strings. And the benefit of the high gain, high attack tone is that we can actually bring the pick out a bit more so that it's just on the edge of the string. If you imagine that's the edge of the string and the pick should be just on the tip of it. It shouldn't be going too low. It should be just right. So you'll find that kind of sweet spot for yourself. It's a very light attack. And by practicing that of the tone and making sure that you've got a separation when you're playing scalic lines, making sure it's nice and light and not too light. You don't want to be dropping the pick and you don't want to be digging in too far, but you want it to be a bit further out. And you'll find that the tone is a lot nicer. And when you do want to dig in, you'll have a bit of juice left in the right hand to be able to get that attack when you want it. Let's just take a quick look at that lick that I improvised in the video. I can't quite remember what happened, but I do remember what I was visualizing on the neck as I played it. So let's take a look at the neck and see how John Petrucci might sequence an alternate picking line like this across the fretboard. So we're nice and zoomed in here. Now, for this lick, you might need 24 frets, but if you don't have 24 frets, we can change this to different keys or just take parts of it that you'd like. This backing track is from Andy James's John Petrucci style quick licks lesson. And it's in E minor, this section. And I started up with these three note per string cells. And we can visualize this in a way that we can see these groups of six. So you've got this group of six here on the E and the B string. So that's 24, 22, and 20. Then we move that down to 22, 20, and 19 on E and B. Then at this point, we're going to shift down another fragment of the three note per string E minor scale, and we're going to go 20, 19, 17 on the E and B, and then continue down to the G string, 19, 17, 16 on the G and D. So far you should have. Then we're going to repeat that G string fragment, then move it down here to 17, 16, 14 on G and D, and then repeat that again, then descend. So at the end there, we have 17, 15, 14 on A and E. So the whole lick slowly. So the next aspect of John Petrucci's approach on guitar is in his sequencing and subdivision groupings. Often he'll mix up his lines between straight and triplet notes, and of course he'll be doing this with sequences as well. And some of the sequences are fairly straightforward, they're textbook sequences, but they're intermingled with some other aspects that we'll be looking at later in this lesson. Be sure to hit the timestamp to look at the section on arpeggios and scales for more info on this subject. But for now, we're going to dive in with the concept of moving between subdivisions and then the concept of sequencing scalic ideas. So within the little solo example that I performed earlier, I was using scalic three note per string reference. So I was in E minor still. Now I can play that scale either with triplets. In fact, let's just take this position. We're going to take the seventh position of E minor. We could play it as triplets, so. So that'd be triplet, triplet, triplet. Or we can do eighth notes. And a really cool thing to practice in your playing beyond just John Petrucci style guitar licks is to be able to move between subdivisions. I could do two beats of eighth notes going into two beats of triplet eighth notes. So. Now this is a really good exercise for synchronizing your picking hand. Often when we're taught to practice our scales when picking, we're told to just go up and down in one subdivision. Which is absolutely fantastic, but can you change gear and keep in time with a good subdivision? That's a really good thing to practice. So you could make any exercise. You could start with triplets and then go into eighth notes. So two triplets and two eighth notes. Now so far, this sounds quite scalic because we're going up and down. But what about if we apply some sequences now? We could take a thirds. So that's just going up in thirds, going from the 7th to the 10th fret, then the 9th fret on the A, and the 7th fret D, and the 10th fret A, and the 9th fret D. So, then doing the same idea within the scale off the D string, etc. You could do that with any pattern. Now, we could do that as triplets. We could do it as eighth notes. Do it 16ths. Now, often he might do things like this, where he might go. That was an improvised example there, but hopefully you could hear that it was kind of moving through some different rhythmic changes. And this is something you'll hear John Petrucci making a lot of his lines and even his riffs out of this kind of concept. So it's something worth practicing, being able to change gears whilst alternate picking. Hope you're enjoying this free John Petrucci guitar lesson so far. If you're really interested in learning some more John Petrucci licks, you can check out some of the packages available at licklibrary.com. The backing track that I'm playing over in these examples comes from Andy James's Quick Lick series on John Petrucci. There's tons of John Petrucci licks in that to pick up. A lot of these ideas you'll see as well kind of reflected in those phrases. So be sure to check the description and see how you can get involved. Anyway, let's continue on to the next playing style and habit of John Petrucci. Now we're going to dive into some of John Petrucci's more melodic habits, yet still these can be combined for your shreddy John Petrucci guitar licks. Now, we're going to combine scales and arpeggios. Scales and arpeggios are synonymous, they're the same thing. So same destination, different routes. What we're going to do here is we're going to look at an exercise which I find very helpful for seeing our sweep arpeggio patterns and our three note per string scale patterns in one area. This is really cool practice technique and also a really nice way of visualizing the fretboard for this style of playing. So for this example, we're going to descend down an E minor arpeggio, starting up here on the 19th fret top E string, all the way down to the root note of the E minor arpeggio on the 19th fret A. I'm picking 19 on the top E, pulling off to 15, playing 17 on the B, going to 16 on the G, 17 on the D, and then 19 on the E. We're playing this as triplets. At this point, we're going to use the index finger to place us into a 3-note per string scale position, and we're going to ascend like so. So here we have 15, 17, 19 on the A. Then we have 16, 17, 19 on the D and the G string. And then on the B string, we have 17, 19, 20. So let's put that together. We could try this with different arpeggios within the key of E minor. Another nice arpeggio you can do is C major. So here, 15 pull off to 12 on the top E. We have 13 on the B, 12 on the G string, 14 on the D, and 15 on the A. So, and then we're ascending. We're going to go 12, 14, 15 on the A string, 12, 14, 16 on the D and the G. And we're going to shift that pattern up one string and up one fret to 13, 15, 17. So. So you can make that an exercise, do it real slow. And of course, that sort of thing gets combined with different subdivisions rhythmically. And you'll also hear John Petrucci doing smaller arpeggios, like three string arpeggios, diatonically, so using the other arpeggios. So that's a nice little idea we can add to our playing. And be sure to combine it with scales. So you might take a three string arpeggio like that. Final tip I have for playing in the style of John Petrucci on guitar is looking at wide intervals in your melodic playing and also creating sequences with wide intervals. This is something you can hear all over the place in his playing. Let me demonstrate what I was thinking about in that playing example that you just heard. So within the key of E minor, we can jump notes in sixths or fifths, or we can do octaves. And fifths and sixths and octaves are kind of fairly wide, yet still very melodic intervals. So we already know fifths probably. If I take the fifth fret on the B string and the seventh fret on the high E string, that's a fifth. I could find all the fifths within E minor on the top pair of strings. I could do a similar thing by finding sixths. There's two different types of sixth that come up in the minor scale. You've got, for example, from E to C, that's a minor sixth. But from, for example, G to E, that's a major sixth. And you can sequence them in a similar way. And then, of course, there's octaves, which is our classic. So using these in melodies and lines is something that comes up a lot in John Petrucci's guitar licks. So here we're going to slide into the top note of each fifth. We're going to go from 5 to 7 on the E, then grab 5 on the B. And then we're going to go from 8 to 10, and then grab 8 on the B string. So. And we could go up here from 10 to 12 on the high E and then grab 10 on the B. So. Then we could go from 12 to 14, grab 12 on the B. So. You could even go, now we're just going to do a semitone one. So that's just 14 to 15 on the high E string and 13 on the B. Then we're going to continue 15 to 17 on the high E string. Grab 15 on the B, and then we're going to do one more from 17 to 19 on the high E, and then 17 on the B string. So. So there's some John Petrucci playing styles and habits that you can add to your own playing for your own musical experimentation. Now, if there's any things you think I might have missed, then please let us know in the comments. What makes John Petrucci's style unique to you? What have you noticed about John Petrucci's style that we could all learn from and get another perspective on our own playing? Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell button for more free guitar lessons, and you'll be notified next time we upload a video. Be sure to check out some of the other videos in this Playing Style and Habits series. There's lots of other artists and lots of other videos coming soon to this YouTube channel. If you'd like to take your guitar playing to the next level, then be sure to check out licklibrary.com. There's lots of great John Petrucci lick lessons and Dream Theater song lessons as well, but there's also other artists and genres. There's lots of stuff about music theory and technique and tone, which will hopefully take your playing to the next level. There's also one-to-one coaching as part of your membership. Be sure to check the description below for more information. Thanks for watching.